music and getting started. I actually made a cheat sheet, but I'm not sure I'm gonna go after the script. First of all, let me say that it's awesome to be able to do this, and the reason I'm doing this video, as you probably understand, is the new board, Denise from Mr. A. And I've been doing these kinds of videos for a couple of years, and the reason that you never seen anyone, any of them, is that I never put them out. I do a lot of videos and then I archive them, basically, because I think I'm very self-conscious, and seeing other people do YouTube videos is inspiring, of course. I think I'm gonna try to step out of my comfort zone a little bit and actually publish this one. I spent, I don't know how many hours I spent on setting up cameras and stuff. I even got a green screen at one point to do videos. But I'm a perfectionist, so it's really, really difficult for me to release something that I'm not 100% satisfied with. And doing videos, as you might understand, is a challenge for many reasons. There's a lot of things that can go wrong. If you notice that the frame rate on this camera is a bit laggy, it's because it's 4K, 60 FPS, a phone. And I wanted to have high resolution because what I'm about to show you is the Denise Mini ITX PCB that Mr. A has designed. He did a semi ATX board, I would call it. It's a little bit longer than a regular ATX board, back in 2010-11. And I actually got one of these original boards in this awesome Checkmate 1500 case. So if you're interested, I can show you that one later. But if we take a look at this one here, I'm gonna try to move my microphone at the same time because the audio skips off otherwise. As you can see, it's through hole almost entirely, and it's really, really dense. This is the fruit, I would say, of almost 10 years of tinkering back and forth on his spare time. Mr. A is if I call myself a perfectionist, he's a totally different league. But here you have it. So this is an Amiga 500 Plus, I would say, with two Soro slots, as you can see here. There's a lot of differences between this one and the old Amy that we released back in 2017. Which he actually finished a lot earlier. It just took a lot of time for us to get things out. And for instance, as you can see here, the CIA, there you go, the CIA chips are the sort of the big ones, the DIP, not the PLCC ones. And there's a lot of features, and I don't know the word for it, but it's he spent so much time creating this that it's insane. And I hope all of you will enjoy it. The reason actually that I decided to do this video today is this. I love the Streacom chassis. I got the, I think it's called FC5, that I had for years, that I have one of my Amis in. But I recently purchased this one, FC7, I think it's called. And the reason for that is that I got the awesome Zorro USB card, the USB Freeway Triton from Maddie. And that one is a little bit too high to fit in the FC5 chassis, so I got this one, and I'm hoping it will be high enough to suit that card. So that's one thing that I thought we'd take a look at together, if you don't mind. I'm gonna try to make these videos maximum of 10 minutes, so I'm not sure if I'll cut them later or if I'll do. I'm hoping to be able to do it in a one-shot session, although that's probably risking it a bit. I don't know if the camera is okay now. It is. And also, I got my kid standing here behind me, staring over my shoulder, wondering who I'm talking to. Let's open this one up.
Looking good, Mr. Carter.
So this one comes with a Piku PSU. Power supply. I haven't tried that one either. But we'll get around to doing that as well.
This is the one. If the iPhone can focus.
So, I'm pretty sure this will do the job. Denise is not particularly picky about the power supply. But I have seen some of the cheaper versions that didn't work well. So that's one thing to think about. Yeah, so I'm gonna cut here and see what the heck is going on, and we'll mount the motherboard. See you on the other side. Right. So I've set some things up here, and I'm so not used to having a microphone in my face. It's super annoying. I forget about it all the time, so apologies in advance if the sound is murky. I don't know if that's a word. Is murky a word? Anyways, here we have Denise. And I'm going to try to move over to this camera here so you can have a look at her. This is a purple board. The ones that we distributed recently are black, as the one I showed you before. Yeah, there you have it. The cable that's in between the two Soros slots is actually a debug serial. So I've attached an ESP8266 to it to be able to easily and remotely check the logs from it. And as you can see, there's a SIM memory here, 72-pin SIM. That's a custom designed SIM by Mr. A that he did specifically for this board. And the reason he did that was that 2 meg SIMs are really difficult to get hold of. And even though you can put a 4 or 8 or whatever, I guess, SIM in there, he decided that it felt better to have a genuine Amiga compatible 2 meg SIM. And this SIM works in the A4000 and the Re Amigas by Chucky and others as well. So yeah, the little header cable that you see here is the video signals. So basically all the signals you need for scan doubler, etc., is available on a little header there, and the floppy drive is beneath it. The audio part of Denise is something that he is particularly proud of, because it's made up of really high quality capacitors and components, so that the audio is like nothing an Amiga has had before. There's also a built-in big ROM support and built-in ROM switch as well that is tied to one of the MCUs. There's both a PIC and an AVR on the board. So the AVR is the one that controls, that sends out the debug serial, for instance. I honestly don't have in my head what different purposes they have. The PIC is handling the PS2 mouse and Amiga keyboard, PS2 keyboard detection. So when you power it up, when you put
a power on the ATX connector without turning it on, it will turn on by itself, just like the computers of old used to do to detect which keyboard you have. What you see here is I actually damaged one of the lanes when I was switching out the CIA circuits there, so I had to patch one of the signals to get the joystick port. I think it was right mouse button that stopped working. That's actually fun, because that's one of the reasons I think I love doing these kind of projects, that I'm forced to learn more and more about the Amiga. Like, the mouse button is attached to pin 31 on Paula, for instance. And Mr. A gave me a full lesson on sorrow on 68K bus mastering and stuff like that. So it's, even though I get like 10% of it, it's 10% more than I knew before. So that's awesome. And we're going to put this in the new case. And Matthew was kind enough to send me one of these. It's the Freeway Triton. So you can read about that online. Sorrow 3 and Sorrow 2 support the USB card. And it supports full speed USB 2.0. I tried it and it works really well. It's got a built-in flash as well. So when it's jumpered to rescue mode, you get an icon on workbench with all the USB stuff on there. So you just click install Poseidon and Triton, the Triton GUI and all that. So this is a lovely card. I'm totally smitten by it. Great work on this. While we're on the topic, I can show you what other cards I have in the arsenal that's going into this machine. This is the old O30 that Mr. A did for Amy back in the day. So it's got an IDE 50 megahertz O30, and I guess it's 6 meg fast ROM, because the Sorrow ROM space only allows for 8 meg, and 2 megs are reserved for this little gem. This is I should have read up on this, so I'm going by memory, so 1,000 apologies for any mistakes I do. This is the Picasso 2 clone that was initially designed by a German fellow. I think it's the guy who did the Phoenix 8000 reverse engineer, George maybe. And then Matze did another version of it, and now Mr. A made a smaller version, basically. And I think that this one uses another GPU. Do we call them GPUs? A Cirrus Logic graphics processor. I think this one has a little faster memory speed. But like I said, I'm an amateur, just like you guys. I just love Amiga hardware and software. And this is the NIC. I won't be able to use this one since it Denise has two Sorrow ports, but this is the Ariadne 2 reverse engineered. So these cards were bundled with Amy back in 2017. One of the features that I mentioned, you know, the little colorish ribbon cable here that provides the signals, the graphic signals, they attach to this little board. So this is a built-in monitor switch. Come on, focus, please. Yeah, this is a monitor switch. Basically, it's one of those little silvery dongles that you put back on the Amiga as well, that gives you a 15-pin VGA. And it connects also to the Picasso card. So that's neat, and there are other, I should mention that here above the floppy port, down here, you see I have two of these plastic heights standing up there. That's because he also designed a couple of different sort of I/O boards that goes in that space. So here is, let me see so I don't lie. This is so you get floppy, you get an external floppy, and on the bottom side you get a CF compact flash for that connects to the IDE on the O30 accelerator in my case. And this is a blank version of the monitor switch. Well, now you focus, you little weasel. I have a couple of other ports that you can I can show you just if it's interesting. This is just a 8 meg fast ROM that it did. Yeah. So let's get to it, shall we? This is going to be a little bit longer, I guess, than I initially. I think your attention span hopefully will be able to handle the extra minutes when it comes to Amiga computing. Let's do it. I forgot one thing, just a quick look at the gorgeous purple and gold PCB of Denise. Huh? Will you look at that? This is what dreams are made of, guys. Seriously. My God. I actually have... Excuse me one second. I recently got the Re-CD32 from Chucky. So, they're both purple. So, it's a nice match. Yeah, anyways. yep, let's get to it. Yeah, I just realized that the USB port on the chassis is, of course, USB 3. So I'll have to remove these and somehow get an extension, whether I'll use the pin header here or the actual USB-A socket there. I don't know. I'll see what I have in my drawers and get back to you. Yeah. Matthew bundled a backplate with a connector for the USB, but unfortunately this one is a little bit tighter than these two, so I'm gonna have to find or just stick some wires, DuPont wires in this or something to finalize it. But I'm not gonna let that stop me right now. Let's get to it, shall we? This is the adapter that I was talking about. You probably all know it. So that's what this little board does. Also, I found this little guy that I haven't shown before. It's basically it's the USB card that I cannot pronounce that begins with T. So it's a reverse engineer of that one. But that lacks a couple of features. So basically when you use it, the Amiga becomes pretty much unresponsive. So using a mouse, for instance, is a no-go. You can barely copy files from it. But it's a nice design. It's a slim card. So let's see. I'm not sure if I'm going to remove these or not. We'll see. Oh, God. I think I'm gonna add some music or something in the post production. Like I said, I've been doing a lot of videos, but I rarely release anything. Swedish people are. There's something in Sweden called Jantelagen that says that you should never think that you're better than anyone else. I think that's something that had. Has affected my ability to showcase my stuff. So there we have it. I'm gonna try to gently. I'm hoping there's a couple of people who has talked about designing a backplate for Denise. There was one made for Amy, so I'm hoping that it will be released soon as well. I don't know how. Let me move this little. Get a better look. Gently, gently. I'm gonna push the USB cable a little bit. Let's see. There we go.
Like a glove.
Let's see there. Yeah.
Fits perfectly, obviously.
So I'm not gonna use the motorized version for this. There are currently the first batch that we made was 50 boards, 50 PCBs. And I would say about half of them, a bit more than half of them is out in the wild currently. I have a few more that I'm waiting for the MCUs that Mr. A is kind enough to program for me so I can put them out. Currently I have a small Tyndall store where these are available for hobbyists alike. Rule number one when mounting PCBs, never fully
screw the port in place.
It's the last one, might need adjustment. There we go.
Noise. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna put some music on top of this.
Just like with a
car tire.
I'm gonna put this out here gently. And now for the exciting moment to see if the Triton actually fits in here. So I think I'm gonna, there's a nice indicator here that says
front.
Front. So you don't put it backwards and fire everything up.
Yeah, definitely gonna fit. Look at that. Huh?
That's awesome. Give it a nice
sort of push.
There we go. There we go. That's awesome. Perhaps I should have mounted this one first, but what the heck? Because I'm thinking I'm going to use the graphics card that Picasso with this one. So it'll be a nice classic. I have
three. I have two Amys.
Three Amys, to be honest, and Denise.
So I've got one just over here that I have a vampire in. And then in the old one, I have a Pi Storm.
So, det är mycket data, as we say in Swedish. So I'm gently gonna put these plastic screws in place to hold the board. A friend of mine was kind enough to publish the full design of these extension boards, at least this one, the VGA one. No, hang on, the floppy one. Sorry, I don't know. But on one of the forums, on a1k.org, is it? So then we just put in this little pin header, like that. Snaps right in place. And this one, Mr. A told me that
do not remove and insert this card too many times. It will damage the gold plating.
And I think I've
done it like five
or six times now. I'm horrible. So I think this is it's going to be in here for a while after this. I know you're gonna comment now that, oh, these can handle like 1,000 inserts. But like I said, he's a picky guy. There we go. And this is the ribbon cable for the RTG that we put in there like this. It's difficult enough. Not difficult, but there's a lot of things that can go wrong when you do this, obviously. And doing it for an audience is something totally different. I can tell you. I'm gonna need some really good lighting here so I can match the CPU socket of the wonderful Motorola 68000. There we go. So I'm just gonna push it gently but firmly. Det ska knaka när man datar. There we go. That's a little knock. Perfect. Two more of these. I'm not very steady in my hands. Too much meds and liquor in the old days, not the actual days. Wow. Will you look at that? Huh? Looks and feels very good, actually. So now I'm gonna try this Pico PSU. This is the one I used before. Hang on, there we go. The iPhone's autofocus. It's really, I don't think it even tries. The other phone I got back there is a Samsung Galaxy. It has a lot better autofocus. I'm using a webcam software thingy. I'm just gonna put this in here. I'm gonna clean up the cables a bit later and fix the USB, the front USB ports, obviously. And also, I do have a slim CD-ROM that will fit perfectly in this case, because it doesn't fit in the small one. Maybe if I cut it a lot, but I don't think, no, it won't, because I put this big cooling fan on the CPU as well. So that's nice. I'm gonna get a CD for this one too. So that's inserted, I think. Oh, don't bend too much. You can't bend the data. And the TV cook has prepared this SD to CF to ID. Awesome. Awesome. Awesome sauce. So I'm just gently gonna put that in there. I got a thing I do with my tongue. You noticed that, right? Yeah. Had it since I was a kid. Look at that. Almost too easy. Huh? So with a CD-ROM, this will be a perfect classic. 030, Picasso 2, and then USB. Not sure what I will do. Oh, hang on. I can use USB Ethernet in this one. So I'll probably get a Wi-Fi dongle that's compatible with the Poseidon. That I will do. That's going to be real nice. So the power and LEDs are down here, the green ones. So I'm just going to put the LEDs where the LEDs go and the power right there. LED important to get plus there. It's important that the text on these tiny pins are aligned, that they are the same way. Otherwise, I can't sleep. I'll wake up in the middle of the night. Have nightmares about it.
Yeah. That's how we roll, baby.
Let's check it out. I'm not gonna put the chassis on and put all the screws in, and then nothing works. I have to open it up again. Old saga. Saga? Speaking of saga, I haven't updated my vampire for ages. I did one of the updates, but then it screwed me over and put in the AROS kickstart and did a lot of funky stuff with the boot menu and that, so I didn't like that. So I went back to 2.12, I think. Yeah, I'm going to grab the PSU, connect everything together, and what do they say on TV? Stay on for more? Whatever. Okay, guys. So we're back, and I'm not going to lie to you. I did test this before, and it seems like the Streacom Pico PSU did not work. At least not with Denise. I'll double check it with a regular PC ATX board later. Anyways, I connected my old Pico PSU, which works. So I thought we'll do like this. I'll enable a serial session to the onboard TTY debug port, and we'll give the ATX, give the power supply power. And I'm gonna turn off this light so you can see that the LED will turn on briefly. That's when it detects the keyboard and does some initial stuff. I'm gonna make this window a little bit bigger so we can read it. And let's see what happens. There we go. And you probably saw that the LED turned on for a sec. So that's it. The board is now connected and working. I'm just gonna double check so there's no short circuits or anything. And I'll turn it on. Let's shake it out. I'm gonna turn this camera and see if I can enable that one instead. So we now see a lot of LEDs on the Triton blinking. So I'm going to switch cameras like that, and here you have her. That's the screen right there. This is a BenQ TFT that supports 15 kilohertz signals natively, so I get both. Since the internal monitor switch was the word I was looking for, this little guy switches for me. I don't have to touch the screen. So there you have it. Denise in all her glory. I'm not going to run CC4 or anything. You all know what CC4 looks like. Yeah. So I really hope you all enjoy building this fabulous board that Mr. A created. I am so honored to been able to be a part of this. I truly love this guy. I thought I'd mention just a few words. There's been some sort of surrounding mystery about why he is chosen to be anonymous and allowed me to produce these boards and sell them, but it's no big mystery. He simply doesn't like all the attention, and he hasn't got any time or spare time to answer emails or be part of the sort of Q&A community and stuff like that, and he probably hates doing YouTube videos. So that's the simple reason why my small contribution to this project is what it is. So, Thank you for watching, and I truly hope you enjoy building Denise. Cheers. Where is it? There is it. Live long and prosper, my friends.